Hi everyone, my name is Szabolcs and I'm a 21 years old engineering student from Hungary. I'm really glad you are here because what you are about to witness is not only the first steps of my YouTube channel, but also the immortalization of an astonishing achievement. Yes, I'm talking about the title of this video. Before I go into any details, I must state that this bulletproof panel I built actually works. It was able to stop an AK-47 bullet fired from 15 meters, and it's also quite thin and lighter than steel. If you can't wait to see the test results, click here to check the torture test video, but I highly recommend you to watch this detailed building instruction first. If you like the content I'm creating, please support me with your subscription, it really means a lot, especially at the beginning, but I will tell you more about this at the end of the video. Now let's get started.
Alright, so this is going to work the same as modern military composite armors. It will consist of layers of different materials, in our case stainless steel, hard ceramic mosaic tiles and most importantly fiberglass. All these are going to be held together by epoxy resin and silicone gel. The motivation behind this project is basically to find out how effective protection can be built from stuff an average person can buy at a relatively low cost, which is around 40 to 50 bucks per piece. This is what I paid for each of these plates. Alright, let's move on. It all starts with cutting the fiberglass sheet. This is woven roving and weighs 490 grams per square meter, which is roughly 14.5 ounces per square yard. This was the densest I could buy here. I ordered 10 meters because I calculated that each panel should use 48 layers of this. The disadvantage of this type of cloth is that the filaments are held together by each other, so if you start cutting, they unravel very easily. As you can see, I'm wearing gloves and for a very good reason. These glass filaments break apart when you cut with a scissor, so if you touch the edges where they are relatively free, the small parts can get on your skin. Once there, they cause itching and even irritation. Very fine parts can even be inhaled, but luckily they are big enough to stuck in the mucus. At least that's what the doctors say. Some hours later, I was finally ready. This clip clearly shows how difficult it is to produce clean cuts. There was loose fiberglass everywhere. Later on, I cut these bigger parts into 33 by 30 cm pieces. I choose fiberglass because it is the cheapest composite fabric and in some light armored military vehicles they actually use it. When combined with resin, it has great mechanical properties. Let's start laminating. I used epoxy instead of phenolic resin because these systems show extremely high 3-dimensional crosslink density, which results to the best mechanical performance characteristics of all the resins. It has excellent strength and hardness and very good heat resistance. As you can see, I layered each piece on top of the other and carefully applied the resin with a cheap brush. The specific type I used has a pot life of half an hour, which means the time it takes to start forming the chemical bonds after you mix the two parts. It also means I had to work fast. I used small quantities at once and it took me nearly 2 hours to finish all 48 layers. I covered both the bottom and the top with a thin plastic wrap to prevent sticking to the press. After 2 days of curing under 50 kg of pressure, it looked like this. It's worth mentioning that when I started the laminating process, the sheets became transparent, but I used so many that it totally disappeared. The edges were sharp as a knife and you could even play a melody on them. Of course, I cut these off. It was very hard and sounded like a tile, I've never touched anything like this before. The final thickness was 1.6 cm, which is better than I expected, and it weighs 3.4 kg, which is, on the other hand, a bit worse than I calculated. Surprisingly, it soaked up almost a kilogram of resin. Now that I had two of these, I could focus on the next component. Note that the right one is slightly smaller compared to the other, to match the hexagonal ceramic grid, which I will show you right after this clip. On a side note, the black marks are where the grinder disc burned the panel. Never do grinding in a closed place, it has a terrible smell and it fills the air with tiny floating glass fibers, which are very dangerous. They are similar to asbestos, so always wear a proper respirator mask. Okay, so the first barricade the bullet will face are small mosaic tiles. The role of the hard ceramic is to deform and slow down the projectile. Usually it loses 40% of its kinetic energy when it hits the tile, resulting in the shattering of the mosaic. Actually, I bought two different types to test which one works better. This hexagonal or honeycomb structure is made from ordinary ceramic and it weighs around 700 grams. While the other from marble and it's much thicker as you can see. It's 8 mm versus 4 mm. I will fill up the gaps with silicone gel. It functions as a shock absorber and makes the grid more flexible. Let's start with the ceramic. It's a slow and messy process, but then I got the hang of it. I use regular bathroom silicone filler. The core of modern vehicle armors are also ceramic tiles, but those are made from boron or silicon carbide. Of course, you can buy these too on Alibaba, but for $100 each. So I guess you see now what I meant when I said low cost. My plate costs less than a single tile. Sure, that stuff was designed to stop bullets and it's awesome, but I suppose you agree with me that none of us can really afford it. I smear the excess amount on the surface so it can provide additional flexibility. It takes a couple of hours to fully harden. I did the same to the marble grid as well. And now let me show you a small animation to demonstrate my idea. As far as I know, I'm the first fan on YouTube using small mosaics instead of one big tile. The advantage of this is that when the bullet hits the panel, it breaks only that one or two pieces, not the whole. This means it is able to withstand more hits without losing the stopping capability. You might say, oh you idiot, what about the gaps between the pieces? Well, first, they are so small and the gaps are so narrow, even the smallest bullet will definitely hit some tiles. And this is when shock absorbing plays a very important role. You don't want that enormous force to break the surrounding pieces. Of course, this is only my theory, but we're gonna test the panels in the next video. I already glued together the honeycomb tiles and the fiberglass panel with the leftover epoxy to see how it works. It seems actually very strong, I hope the impact won't break off the whole thing. All I had to do now is to put epoxy on the back of the marble grid and on the top of the fiberglass, place the two together, apply pressing force and wait. You must clean the surface before gluing because any dirt or flow can decrease the efficiency of the bonding. One very important fact that some people often forget is that this resin needs 7 days to achieve its final mechanical state. Chemical reactions doesn't occur after a day or so, but some changes still happen in those days. I did wait a week with both panels. The next thing was to get the front and backing plate, so I went to the local scrapyard and scavenged a 2mm thick stainless steel plate. I marked the lines, then prepared for cutting. These two bigger ones will be for the marble mosaics and these smaller ones for the ceramic. Aluminium would have been much better because it is almost 3 times lighter than steel. The main role of these metals isn't to provide a hard surface, but to create a rigid frame you can put the core elements into. Now that I had everything ready, I could finally put together the whole thing. In the meantime, the marble grid hardened nicely as well. Normally, the metal plates should be welded together, but since we want to see inside and examine the damage each bullet does, I choose other methods. On the ceramic plate, I will tape the edges with this strong duct tape, then place the panel in a wooden holder. I also use clamps like this to keep the plates in place while I worked on them. In the case of the marble panel, I started to drill 3 holes on each end to place these bolts in. They should provide enough force to simulate real circumstances. And that's it guys, my first project is ready. I placed these white plastic sheets on the front in order to indicate the target points. Because these were only prototypes, I learned a lot and gained enough information to build even better ones. I continuously get new ideas on how to improve this concept. Maybe I will build it so strong it can withstand a full magazine of an SMG. Oh wait, maybe I just did. But that belongs to the next video. In that, I will take these to the firing range and test them against different bullets fired from handguns, an AK-47 and even a Dragunov sniper rifle. See you there. Alright people, I hope you enjoyed this little project I made. I definitely did while I was working on it. Don't forget to check out the ballistic test, you can click right on the video and I will leave a link in the description as well. My next project will be a liquid armor vest or a bulletproof glass panel, I haven't really decided yet. But it also depends on you. I set up a Patreon page where you can find many other useful stuff and you can help me get the necessary financial support, for example buying a new microphone, or you can even decide on what content you want to see next. As a student, I greatly depend on others, but with your subscription and support on Patreon, I can produce more content in the topics you are interested in and in the quality you all well deserve. Thanks for watching and have a nice day!